Mobile World Congress 2018 is over, and we're slowly getting a better picture of what Google's new Android Go initiative will look like. Android Go is a special configuration of Android 8.1, with a selection of special Go apps, that targets low-end devices with 1 GB of RAM or less. MWC has seen a ton of manufacturers sign up for the program and announce phones shipping with the Go config, so it's time for a hardware roundup. Let's go. HMD, the licensee of the Nokia brand for phones, seems like the most cooperative third-party OEM out there, recently announcing that every phone it makes will be part of Google's Android One stock Android program. For the Android Go program, it has the Nokia One. For $85 you get a 4.5-inch 854x480, 16:9. IPS display powered by a 1.1 GHz quad-core MediaTek mount 6737M, Cortex-A53-based, SoC, 1 GB of RAM, and a 2150 mAh battery. Android Go's low storage requirements will be needed here, since it only has 8 GB of internal storage, plus a microSD slot. Besides that, you get an old-school micro-USB port, a headphone jack, LTE, GPS, 802.11 BGN, Bluetooth 4.2, and there are optional dual SIM modules. There's no NFC, no fingerprint reader, and no dust or water resistance. The Nokia One brings back an old-school phone concept, swappable back shells called Nokia's press covers. You can peel off the colored plastic back shell and replace it with a different color for a new look. This also means the battery is, get this, replaceable. When you take off the back, you can actually pull the battery out and, if you have an extra on hand, replace it with a fully charged battery. Amazing. Since Android Go is normal Android with a special configuration, OEMs are still allowed to skin it. But Nokia's spec sheet helpfully points out that there are no skins and no UI changes to Android. Country availability for all of these phones seems a little iffy, but Nokia's spec sheet lists specific versions for EMEA, Europe, the Middle East, and Africa, APAC, Asia Pacific, LATAM, Latin America, Australia, and India. None of these regions points to a US version. TCL, the licensee of the BlackBerry brand for phones, is joining the Android Go party with the Alcatel 1X. Not to be confused with the Alcatel X1. The 1X is interesting since it's a kind of mini flagship design, with an extra tall 18:9 display and an optional rear fingerprint reader. It's also the most confusing phone on our list. The pricing starts at €100, about $122, but there are something like 7 models combining different RAM amounts, cameras, cellular bands, optional fingerprint readers, optional NFC, and optional dual SIM, so nailing down the exact price with the specs you want is pretty hard. There doesn't seem to be a best version, either, since you can get either a fingerprint sensor or NFC, but not both. There's even a version with 2 GB of RAM and a better camera, but that doesn't come with Android Go, so we'll ignore it. The display is always a 5.3-inch. 960x480 pixels IPS LCD. The 1X comes with some kind of quad-core MediaTek SoC. The website says every model has a 1.3 GHz MTK 6580, while the press release says it's a 1.28 GHz MD 6739. We have asked TCL to clarify, but, either way, it uses Cortex-A53 cores. For the base specs you get 1 GB of RAM, 16 GB of storage, a microSD slot, and a 2460 mAh battery. For the rear camera, Alcatel says it has an 8-megapixel sensor that is then interpolated to 13 megapixels. We have no idea why a company would want to do this. This seems to suggest the software will take an 8-megapixel image and blow it up to a larger size, which usually makes an image blurrier and uglier. It's not like 8 megapixels is a low resolution, that works out to something like 3264x2448, which is plenty for the 960x480 display. Won't this just make the image worse? Besides that, you get a micro USB port, a headphone jack, LTE, GPS, 802.11bgn, and Bluetooth 4.2. The real downside to this device will probably be the skinned version of Android. If Go is supposed to be light and fast, doesn't skinning defeat the purpose? In terms of availability, so far there's no word on if this is US bound or not. The ZTE Tempo Go isn't the most interesting Android Go phone, but it is one that is actually coming to the US. US bound means this is the rare Android Go phone that isn't using a MediaTek chipset. For $80 you get a Qualcomm Snapdragon 210, 1 GB of RAM, 8 GB of onboard storage, a 2200 mAh battery, a 5 MP rear camera, and a 2 MP front camera. The Snapdragon 210 uses 4A7 CPU cores, which are absolutely ancient and aren't even 64-bit. The design isn't great either, with a 5-inch 854x480 display and old-school capacitive hardware navigation buttons. The buttons aren't even labeled well, you get a home button and two dots. As usual, there's an old micro USB port, a micro SD slot, LTE, and a 3.5mm headphone jack. Plenty more companies announced specific Android Go modules at Mobile World Congress, or at least they announced an intention to create an Android Go phone in the future. Google has a blog post rounding up the announcements, but we have the most interesting ones detailed above. Here's the rest of the field. Google's blog post mentions that the General Mobile GM8 Go was announced and is coming to people in Turkey and around the world, but there seems to be almost no coverage of it out there. There's nothing on General Mobile's website, and while pre-MWC there was a leak saying the existing GM8 device would get a GM8 Go version, there's no announcement coverage out there that we could find. What's really weird is that the GM8 seems way too high-end, with 4 GB of RAM, for Android Go. Google says Huawei has also committed significant resources to Android Go, with a device coming to all major emerging markets in the near future. Indian OEM Lava International Limited is making the Lava Z50 for India only. It's roughly along the same lines as everything else in the above list. Another Indian OEM making a Go phone for India only, the Micromax Informatics Bharat Go. A company called Trenchin will be releasing Android Go phones in a diverse set of international markets, particularly Africa. So far, Android Go phones all seem to hover around $100, which should be enough to make a cheap, but good smartphone. A $100 price tag is actually not the bottom of the pricing market. Remember, there are still devices out there like the $10 Walmart phone we reviewed a few years ago. Everything seems to push right up against the high end of the allowed Android Go specs. The announced phones also seem to mostly focus on the developing world. But when we last spoke to Google about Android Go, about 2 months ago when it was released to OEMs, we was told Google expects it to take hold in the low end of the market pretty much everywhere, particularly in prepaid markets. We had guessed there aren't many companies that want to bother with a coordinated launch push for low-end phones, so while Mobile World Congress is the beginning, we'd expect a steady trickle of Android Go phones in the future. Let us know your thoughts concerning these new Android Go devices. To discover more Android-related video, don't hesitate to subscribe to the S. Sorrells channel.